The Health Resources Department needs to keep an eye on what helps are doing. This site was done in a hurry, and they would appreciate if you would take a look. This is the description of Health Resources, an easy to medium difficulty web challenge from the X-MAS CTF 2022. For this challenge, we have to go blind and adopt a black box approach, as we don't have the source code of the application or other information that can be useful. The attack surface is very restricted. We are presented with three different buttons requesting three snowmans and nothing else. There are no comments or helpful information inside the source code, neither cookies nor JWT. It is quite obvious that the most reasonable entry point is the snowman ID, so we can try to play with that parameter and analyze the application behavior. Providing to the application some IDs that do not exist in the database, we can see that it returns some internal errors. Trying to perform some arithmetical calculation, however, something strange happens. The math operation is somehow executed by the server, meaning that the ID is neither escaped nor sanitized, but instead is passed as is to a query that performs the mathematical instruction, returning then the snowman corresponding to the final elaborated value. Alright, this sounds very promising. Probably we have control over some SQL parameters. We can try some basic SQL injection payload and understand if we are correct or wrong. After some trial and error that took us some time, we discovered that the application is vulnerable to Boolean-based SQL injection, but it requires that the payload is URL encoded with the hexadecimal representation, otherwise it won't work. To facilitate and make those kind of tests faster, I installed and used Hackvector, a free tag-based conversion tool that automatically encodes and escapes values included inside the supported tags. Perfect, at this point we can try to dump the database content. To speed up the process, we used sqlmap, a tool specifically designed to exploit those kind of vulnerabilities. But be careful when using sqlmap, because this tool generates lots of requests and may even cause disservice. Always use it mindfully and do not abuse it. sqlmap confirmed our finding and also discovered that DBMS in use, in this case SQLite. Then it was able to dump the helps table, but while extracting its content it failed, returning only the helps ID but missing the data. During the CTF, we mistakenly thought the column was empty, spending a lot of time searching under rows. But then a member of the team noticed that sqlmap actually found something. It had not just been able to pull it out. So we used the suggested flag, and this time we were able to extract also the data column. As soon as we got the values, our teammate recognized they were serialized Python objects. Decoding the base64 string is indeed possible to recognize some Python-like strings, and for the meme, also asking ChatGPT which kind of data we had, it tells us that maybe it could have been a serialized object. If you don't know what serialization and deserialization are, I suggest you watch my old video Pickle Insecure Deserialization. There, I explain the basic concept about insecure deserialization vulnerabilities and how to exploit them, so make sure to understand the topic to get the most from the current challenge. However, to summarize very briefly, Python developers usually implement the Pickle module to manage serialized objects. This module, however, can become dangerous when used to unpickle untrusted data, as the official documentation also says, and it's most likely this challenge scenario. At this point, we have to face two different issues. We have to understand how the server class was built, so we can reproduce it inside our custom script and generate valid objects, and then we have also to understand how to pass those arbitrary objects to the server so that it deserializes them and executes our code. The first task is relatively simple. Looking at the fields inside the database and the data inside one of the three objects, we can see the server is using a very simple class named Health, having just an ID, a name, and an activity as properties. With that in mind, my friend and teammate Messapo wrote a simple script that uses this class and Pickle to generate a malicious serialized object that executes arbitrary commands once deserialized. The second task requires some assumption to be solved, which is the internal logic of the backend. How can we affect which object will be deserialized? At first, we assumed that the server was appending our controlled parameter to a query used to access a specific file or path, causing server-side request forgery or local file inclusion. However, when we saw the objects in the database, we immediately changed our mind and realized that the server probably uses the ID to specify which objects to deserialize. Okay, so in which way do we force the server to deserialize our custom object? We can try writing in some way a custom row inside the database, but we can also try to directly pass the object using a blind union-based SQL injection query. The second alternative seemed the most effective, and indeed, passing an already existing object to a non-existing ID using a union query returned a valid snowman's page, confirm it that we can pass and deserialize arbitrary data to the application. Here we go, it's time to exfiltrate some data, but not before I exfiltrate your subscription to the channel and your like. Seriously, it would be appreciated so much, so thanks in advance. Because with our payload we cannot print the data on the screen, we must receive the command's output through a different channel. In this case, we force the backend send a GET request to our controlled HTTP server, so that we can extract and decode the LS output once arrives. Cool, the flag is right inside the same folder as the application. We can update our payload to send us the file's content and so extract the flag. Let's decode it. X-MAS, Health Human Resources will be contact you soon. Nice, I also found a new job opportunity. However, we haven't finished yet. Since we can exfiltrate anything from the server, let's take a look to the source code of the vulnerable web application. Let's change the get method to post so that the source code is not cut off, and then let's add the -W0 flag to prevent base64 from inserting unwanted new lines. We got it. Let's open the gateway interface and decode the exif parameter so that we can check the code and see where the vulnerability is. Inspecting the code, we can see that the /elfid root directly inserts the elfid within a query to extract the serialized data, but without performing any security checks. Injecting our custom object using the union query, we can force the fetch one instruction to set the value of the data variable with untrusted objects that are then deserialized, eventually causing a remote code execution. In this case, the application should verify that the ID passed to the backend is indeed an integer and does not contain any other characters, thereby preventing any injection attempt by attacker. It should also implement parameterized query instead of appending user input directly to the end of the query string. This was our solution and breakdown for Health Resources. Did you participate to the CTF? Do you have other suggestions or tips to exploit this kind of scenarios? Let me know it in the comment section below. Thanks to everyone who stayed with me up to here. I hope you enjoyed the video and that you find it helpful. If so, please consider leaving me a like and subscribe to the channel so that we can meet again in the coming videos. Having said that, see you next time. Ciao.